Welcome, this is me trying to upgrade my boot drive SSD. Note that this is not a tutorial. So let's begin our journey by introducing the beast itself. Yeah, this is my Lenovo IdeaPad 320. I have been using it for the past 3 years. It's working Intel Core i5-7200U with NVIDIA GeForce 920MX. It has a 12GB of memory, and lastly, 12GB SSD boot drive and 1TB HDD for mass storage. Alright, now the cover has been removed. You cannot see the SSD. Damn it, why is it so dark here? Anyway, this is a 120GB Kingston A400 SSD. Ta-da!
If you want to buy this at Shopee, description.
I bought this SSD 2 years ago. Back then it was around 150 ringgit plus the caddy for my hard drive, but it's getting more affordable now.
So buy using the link in the description.
Moving on, let's see how this SSD performs.
Honestly, the read and write speed did not meet the expected result from a SSD, but this is old drive, so I let it slide.
So now, let's swap that old SSD with a new one that I bought. Say hello to my puppy BX500 from Crucial.
Link in the description if you wanna buy one.
Here is a little bit of unboxing and review of the product if you want to feel the experience. So in the box you will get the SSD itself and a manual in multiple language. But who reads the manual, am I right? Those are for losers. I bought the 480GB version because I don't think I'll be needing more than that, so it's fine. This beast does not cyberpunk anyway. This is also a budget SSD, almost exactly the same as the Kingston A400. So I got this SSD for around 199 minus the shipping of course from Shopee.
Link in the description.
Now is the time to install this puppy. So far, this seems easy enough. After done installing the SSD, we close the cover and screw it up. Done. Oh, so I thought. Right now, you're probably wondering why the screw is out again. Haha. It is because of installation error. Recovery, major drivers missing, cannot install Windows, file corrupted. It's all because of bad USB drive. So I made another one using another USB drive. Now it's waiting time. Dr. K, everybody? Anybody? Just me. Okay.
Or an acquaintance of yours, putting her thoughts and feelings above yours is a mistake. You make sacrifices for the people that deserve your sacrifice. And I was like, oh fuck. The point is trying. The point is that we've started giving up. And that's what we're here to, like, stop.
Okay. Enough Dr. K for now. Let's do some research on this.
I'm really hoping I can find the solution fast because I am tired.
Hi guys, this is Jude from EasyTex. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you two. The second method is to use a third-party application to create your Windows 10 bootable USB. Here I'll be using Rufus, but before downloading and running Rufus, you need to have your Windows 10 ISO file saved somewhere on your computer. Here select create a USB, select the location where you want that location. You should find a file like this called windows.iso. You go to Google and search.
This guy Rufus. Might be onto something. Rufus? The heck is a Rufus? I need Rufus. Movie time! How to train your dragon with my girlfriend over the phone. Exciting! Long distance relationship. Taking way longer than I anticipate. I am really, really tired. Is what a loser would say. Hey!
6 hours later.
It's done. I successfully installed Windows 10 Home on it, installed OBS, and now let's check the speed. For comparison, this is the Kingston A400 we tested earlier. Compare that to first clean Windows install and after a bunch of application installed on the SSD. Definitely an improvement, I would say. Hey, you made it till the end. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. Bye.